Did that sound good? Now that was from a vinyl record recorded by Bruce Springsteen in January of 2009. The CD version, by comparison, sounds like crap. And you'll hear why in just a minute. Now, how did that sound? Loud, I bet. It certainly was much louder than the vinyl rip, and that kind of loudness has become all the norm for CDs and MP3s released today. And this, folks, is what the loudness war is all about. Who has the loudest song? You guys want a more contemporary example?
Goodbye.
Good riddance.
Hold up. Only rapper to rewrite history without a pen. No ID on the track, let the story begin. Begin. This is anti-auto-tune, death of the ringtone. This ain't for iTunes, this ain't for sing-alongs. This is Sinatra at the opera, bring a blonde. Preferably with a fat ass who can sing a song. Wrong, this ain't politically correct. This might offend. Rapper to rewrite history without a pen. No ID on the track, let the story begin. Begin. This is anti-auto-tune, death of the ringtone. This ain't for iTunes, this ain't for sing-alongs. This is Sinatra at the opera, bring a blonde. Preferably with a fat ass.
So, now what exactly is the loudness wars? And how does it affect you, you may be asking? Well, years ago, talking the 1960s when records were first coming out, some record executive decided that his record had to be louder than everybody else's. And the theory was that the louder a song is, the more people that would notice it. When CDs were invented in 1984, the maximum loudness of a song was increased, meaning records could be much louder than they once were. As you will see for this next clip, the CD version of this particular song is much louder than the original 1982 vinyl release. And the reason for this being, as I mentioned earlier, is that the maximum loudness or volume for a vinyl disc was much lower than CDs were, and unfortunately record companies abused this power way too much even back in the early days of CDs. So, you may be asking once again, how exactly does this affect me and my enjoyment of music? Well, take a look at this next song. I'm going to give you both versions once again. And I want you to tell me what it is, the difference is between the two of them, aside from the overall volume. I think you might be surprised at the answer you come up with. So, did you notice what was missing on the top of the iTunes waveform that the vinyl did have? The iTunes one was missing all the peaks and crescendos that punchy vocals, drums, or anything that stands out from the other stuff in the music can produce. When that stuff is compressed, what you're left with is everything sounding at the same volume. This is so that the overall volume can be increased. But is it really better if it sounds that way? To give you guys an example and an idea of how bad this problem has been getting over the past few years, I'm going to show you three songs. One is from 1998, one is from 2004, and one is from 2008. Notice how much louder the songs keep getting until they finally reach the breaking point in 1998, and we'll talk about that in a minute.
I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. If I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night.
I feel like this is coming to an end, and it's better for me to let it go now and hold on and hurt you. I gotta let it burn.
It's gonna burn for me to say this. It's coming from my heart. It's been a long time coming, but we didn't bend, fell apart. We really wanna work this out, but I don't think it's gonna change. I do, but you don't. Think it's best we go our separate ways. Tell me why I should stay in this relationship.